We would love to play first. Eh, this hand is not great, but I think I usually tend to keep the very mana heavy hands. Usually you'll draw something to do, and the gas spells in this deck are pretty gassy, so a lot of mana is hard to go wrong with. All right, looks like we're playing against Abzan. Yeah, I'd rather scry because we're gonna have 5 mana anyway, which casts almost everything in the deck. So getting to potentially draw a card off the scry is pretty huge. Keep that one on top. And now we have the option between playing another Mystic or playing the Caryatid. And I want to play the Caryatid actually to play around Bile Blight. If he Bile Blights both of our Mystics, we don't get to play Xenagos next turn, which would be slightly disastrous. And all it does is get in an extra point of damage, so it's not really that big a deal. Okay, now we will get Xenagos in the mix. And obviously make a 2/2. I guess this time we'll cast the Elvish Mystic. If he wants to spend his next turn casting Bile Blight, that would be pretty good for us. All right, looks like Xenagos is gonna get downfalled. And we're gonna brick. I think I'll hold Reclamation Sage for Courser. Like, I don't think we're gonna win this game by having an extra 2/1 on board. So, I'd rather do that. Played Wooded Foothills there over the forest because if we draw Courser, having a fetch land already in play is pretty nice. Okay. Interesting. These cards do not often go together. So, for example, because we played the fetch land over the forest last turn, now we get to fetch, potentially hit a land here, and clear a dead card off the top. We want to find forest. Something important to keep in mind with this deck is that forests are much better than mountains, both because of Cord and because of Citizen Tactics. You get paid for having a lot of forests in play. You can strive. You can. I think it's called Strive, whatever that mechanic is called, more. Well, Stormbreath is gonna be good, I hope. It usually is. So I think we'll just take 4 from Anafenza here. Maybe it's holding back even. Is there a rhinoceros coming down? No, just a fleece mane lion. And a death dealer. Huh. Okay. Very curious about Jungle Hollow in this deck. All right, I don't think we really want to draw a Courser next turn, so we'll go ahead and fetch. Ooh, Hornet's Nest will be great though. Because if he has a hero's downfall, he's going to have to use it on this Stormbreath Dragon. Or risk dying very quickly. And then our Hornet's Nest should be actually very good. That's annoying. So, it's just getting in with everyone. Putting a counter on the Death Dealer. Well, this isn't actually that bad. I guess we just go trade here, trade an Elvish Mystic for that, and then trade there, and then we can Reclamation Sage the Whip next turn. Yeah, if we hit a if we don't do this, if we just like don't block as much and we hit a land next turn, we could alternately try and play the Sage and Monstrous the Stormbreath Dragon, but I think this just seems better. It clears off most of his creatures. And then we can just go like Hornet's Nest, Sage, and have a pretty stabilized board for ourselves. He does gain a bunch of life, which is annoying. But we can crack back for 6. That's even worse than a land. This is a very interesting Abzan build that we're playing against. I just want to go ahead and Monstrous and get in. Basically deals 11 damage this turn. I think there's no reason to mess around. Just get him dead. Alright. Stormbreath carries us to victory. So, I don't know entirely how to sideboard because our opponent's deck is so unusual. Typically, I would cut Nylea's Disciple and one Hornet's Nest and like a Court of Calling, or the Reclamation Sage, actually. But because he has Whip, I want to keep the Sage. And I'm not sure how aggressive he is. He has a lot of 2-drops, but then he also has, like, Reaper of the Wilds, which is not very aggressive. And I think it's probably fine to cut the Disciple. It's probably not super necessary. I like Ashcloud Phoenix a lot in this matchup. They have to have Abzan Charm, or you get the 2-for-1 most of the time. Although, if he's more aggressive, it's less good. And he has Anafenza. Yeah, maybe we'll just have one and bring one in. Bring in the Crater's Claws for sure. I really like that card in this matchup. And I think I'll keep all the nests, actually. Well, no, I'll still cut one. The problem with nest in the post-board games is they always have, like, drown and stuff like that. So it's a little worse. Chandra also looks kind of bad, but I think it's still pretty good. In your aggressive draws, it comes down, pings a guy, and, like, lets you get in, and they can't even kill it in one hit with a Rhino. It might not be great. Arbor Colossus might be better. But I'm going to try this for now.